Hi Leo, welcome to your weekly reading with me. This is Brooke and welcome back to Nightbird Tarot. Thank you for joining me. This is your weekly reading for February 26th to March 4th. Please make sure to watch for your sun, moon, rising in this video. So Leo, we come in with the energy of the Six of Cups for the week. This is essentially from the past. So this could be return of someone from the past. This could pertain to ex-partners, ex-girlfriend, ex-boyfriend, anything connected to Leo's past. This even could have been a situation from the most recent past or even long-term past. Okay, so something is coming back in for Leo connected to your past with the Six of Cups energy. Now, there seems to be something where Leo is either going through emotional pain, physical pain. This could have been minor surgery for Leo. There seems to be a need for pain management. This even could be taking it easy, moderation. This also could be actual heartbreak that Leo is going through because this is a general reading. So we come in with the Three of Swords energy, and then we come in with Temperance. So the Three of Swords and Temperance together, there is a need for moderation and balance this week for Leo. There's been a short-term, and when I say short-term, I mean immediate. So anything that has occurred within the last 3 weeks, so immediate. So there's been some sort of breakup or short-term event that has caused heartache. Or this could even actually indicate some type of physical pain that Leo has endured. There's a need this week to take a break for moderation to come in with Temperance. So Temperance is archetype Sagittarius. For many, you could be dealing with Sagittarius energies. But there's a need for Leo to really pay a close attention to your body, to your mental state, your emotional state, therefore your physical state. So to really focus upon what's going up in here is essentially affecting Leo in some way, or if there's any type of physical pain that Leo is dealing with, or emotional pain, okay, it's very much affecting you. Could be something very much connected definitely to the past. Past surgery, past breakup, past situation that may have caused you emotional trauma, okay? Anything that is concerning Leo, concerning the past. Then we come in with the Court card. We have the Queen of Pentacles, and then we come in with the Star. So the Star's energy is Aquarius, the Queen of Pentacles, potential Earth sign, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. However, the Queen of Pentacles, you know, she really has good intentions for Leo. She almost comes in as a spiritual or wise counsel. She's very much something that is taking care of Leo this week, or is helping Leo, or is giving Leo words of wisdom, or is giving Leo faith or hope, or is a healer to Leo as well. So this Queen of Pentacles is nurturing Leo in some fashion. This could even be in the workplace. This also could be in relationships. This could be your mother giving you advice about a relationship. You know, this could be a best friend, close friend giving Leo help or healing or nurturing, or giving Leo some type of, they're telling me, safety net or safe place or safe haven for Leo to inhabit or to dwell in or to be around. So there's some sort of healing process coming in for Leo this week. There's also something surrounding new beginnings. We come in with the Three of Wands energy plus the Three of Cups together. They're in pairs. So this is definitely actually a three threes. Three threes in your reading this week, Leo. So I'm a big reader about numbers. And when I see a repetition of numbers, I pay attention to that because threes very much indicate new beginnings. They very much indicate something that is starting. So there's this new start for Leo this week. There could be a new start in relationships. There could be a new start in friendships. There could be perhaps the new beginnings of birth, pregnancy for many. There also could be some sort of new start or celebration for many as well. For some Leos out there, celebrating something. This could be the celebration of moving forward in your life with the Three of Wands. Very much about looking out to the future now for Leo. So Leo's embracing this. They're very much embracing this new start in their lives. And it's an indicator of starting to kind of, where once before Leo might have been seeing things through a narrow lens, they're telling me is now your world's kind of opening up and you're starting to see different possibilities of your life, and you can go into this direction or you have more options and you're starting to see results show up or to see results coming in about this. So it seems as if Leo's branching out this week with something. Could be something very connected or stemming from the past. The past could have been a launching pad for Leo to go forward with something. There's a need for happiness. You know, Leo's feeling or is going to be feeling more positive coming up. We come in with the Sun card. Okay, so there's a great need for being around friends. There's a great need for celebrations. There's a great need for good times and friends. You may come across a situation, however, in a group event. This even could be in the workplace. It doesn't have to necessarily mean that you're out and about with friends, but it could be a situation like that where there may be someone who is really trying to win something over on Leo, almost trying to kind of like, and we had this come up for you last week, you know, something about a jealous. Okay, well, the jealous seems to be somewhere in the midst of a group of people. This could be in a group of friends. This could be in the workplace. This could be in the family. Someone seems to really just kind of want to put one in there for Leo, or kind of jab you a little bit, or maybe kind of surprise you with cutting words or underhanded compliment or an insult that's kind of under the radar, and you're kind of like, what did they say? So just be on the lookout for that, and you're going to realize, Leo, your limitation with that person if you haven't already, with the Five of Swords energy. Very much driven by the ego. They're very much, perhaps, once again, jealous of you, feeling competitive with you, however you want to phrase it. So someone, or this could even be with more than one person, for Leo is, they have an edge about them. I don't believe it's coming from this Queen of Pentacles. This Queen of Pentacles is here to guide Leo, to help Leo, to help Leo get over something. But there seems to be perhaps snotty remarks or snide remarks from a group of people, okay, surrounding an event or where you're out having a good time. And it's just kind of like they want to throw you under the bus type of situation. We come in with the Moon. The Moon's archetype's Pisces, could be dealing with Pisces energy. But the Moon is very much about deception. So there seems to be a traits of dishonesty floating amongst Leo. They're telling me kind of like floating up here, you know, and Leo's antenna or Leo's radar is kind of picking up on this from certain individuals. And there's an element of, you know, trickery or deception or an element of shadiness coming from a certain area of your life, and you may very well know who I'm talking about or what I'm talking about, and may very well be something connected to someone from the past. If someone does return this week, just be careful. If, you know, the past really should stay in the past. I'm a big believer of that, I remember, you know, long, long, long time ago, I wanted to reconnect with old lovers or old boyfriends or whatever. And quite honestly, you know, you can't change a zebra's stripes. I'm sorry, but you really just can't. So if you don't want this person to be in your life anymore, you may see them out and about. You may have a situation this week where you're out with friends or out with your particular boyfriend, girlfriend, partner. There may be a situation where they, you know, try to make an ass of themselves in front of you. Okay. They're wanting to kind of get into Leo's life again. The moon card tells me that their intentions, there's deceptive traits to their intentions. They may tell you that they've changed, but they really haven't changed. There seems to be an element of deception still closely tied to this person. So really just be on the lookout for that, especially if things going on at night. You know, if you get a booty call at 2 a.m., just ignore it. If someone knocks on the door, don't let them in. If you don't want them in your life, okay? Really think about the consequences of the following day. That's a little bit of Brookie's girlfriend advice, because been there, done that. Just be careful. Do you really want them to come back into the door? Do you really want to open that door up again of Pandora's box? Because someone's really filtering things out for Leo and giving you a lot of life lessons or advice, or really trying to help you get over something or to heal, okay? Because the pain is still being felt for Leo in some regard. So good luck to you, Leo. I hope this reading was helpful. Please subscribe. Check out my website below, as well as my social media, Facebook, Instagram, and I'm on Podbean. I have a podcast. So thanks for watching, Leo. Have a great week, and I'll speak to you soon.